Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video, let us see some more Git commit related topics. So first, let us see configuring Git default editor. So in the previous video, we have seen how to use the git commit command using the hyphen m flag. And if you are not specifying hyphen m flag, then it will open a default editor based on our selection. Then we can specify the commit message there and then we can commit it. Okay, now let me show you how we can configure the default editor and how we can put the commit message in the editor as well instead of using the hyphen m flag. So now I am in the Ansible project, so there is nothing to commit. So let me make some changes. Let me edit the inventory. Okay, here I'm adding serverd.acg.com. And now if I run git status, there is a changes not staged for commit. So let me add git add. We can put dot. And now there is changes to be committed. So now instead specifying the hyphen m flag, I'm just going to run git commit dot. So now it will open up the default text editor. So I have the Vim as the default editor. So here you can click on I to be in the insert mode and you can put the commit message here. Okay, now I can click on escape to exit from the insert mode and colon W Q for saving this. So now if I run git status, there is nothing to commit, working tree clean. Okay, so to check the default editor which is configured already, you can use the git config command, git config code.editor. So I have Vim as the default editor. So if you want to change this, you can use the git config global and code.editor. For example, if I want to change it to nano editor, I can mention nano. And now if I run core editor, I get the output saying nano is my default editor. So I want to change it back to Vim. So based on your preference, you can configure this editor. Let me show you the documentation where you can specify. There are different editor available, so based on your preference you can set the editor. So in this git config documentation here, there are so many editors. So here you can see Atom and gedit for Linux, and this is for Windows, gvim, and Sublime Text for Mac OS. Sublime Text, there is a Windows as well. And this is for Vim. So you can use git config global code.editor Vim. And if you're using Visual Studio Code, then you can use this command to set up the default editor for your Git. Okay, so I'll give this link in the description so that you can refer it. So for a single line message, we can even use the -m flag to specify the commit message. But whereas there are some cases where you need to mention multiple lines of commit message, so in that case, using this editor will be very useful. For example, from this block, here's the template for commit message. So I'm just going to just copy this for some commit message, and I'm going to. So there is nothing to, there is no changes. Let me make some edit. So let me delete this line and save it. So git status, there is a modification. So let me add it, git add. Okay, so let me commit it now, git commit. And here, I can just, let me copy this again. Okay, so let me add it here. So it looks like that's the VM, and I'm not able to copy it. So let me check. Okay, now I have opened it from the VM Firefox. So let me go to the editor, and now let me try to paste it. Okay, now let me save this commit message and exit. So now if I run git status, there is nothing to commit. And if I run the git log, okay, now you can see here the complete message, the commit message that we have provided, which is a bigger one. And this is the previous commit message, which is in a single line. And these are the previous commit. Okay, sometimes, you know, when you are working on a project, it may require to put bigger commit messages. So here, you can specify the bullet points and typically hyphen or asterisk used for the bullet and followed by a single space, and use a hanging indent, and write your commit message in the imperative. So the commit messages that you can mention it in the present tense, and we can put more detailed explanatory text if necessary. Okay, so that is how you can use the text editor, and based on your preference, you can set the default text editor, and you can use that. Okay, so that's it in this video, and I'll see you in the next. Thank you.